Today we are learning about bubble sort. What is a bubble sort? What is the mechanism of bubble sort? How we can implement bubble sort of any given array? So our topic is today is bubble sort. First of all, we have to understand some different things about bubble sort. First of all, it is a in-place sorting. It is a in-place sorting. What does it mean? What is the mean of in-place sorting? In-place sorting means it doesn't require any extra space for sorting. It doesn't require any extra space for sorting. For sorting, okay. It's mean like, for example, I'm giving example also. Let's say there is an array. An array required 10 KB space. Array required 10 KB space. So by using bubble sort also, we don't require any extra space. Array will be sorting by these 10 KB space only. Array does not require any extra space for sorting. So this is a in-place sorting, bubble sort. Now the next thing is that it is a comparison base. It is a comparison-based sorting method. It's a comparison-based sorting method. It means we have to be compare numbers. We have to be compare numbers in pairs. Okay, so this is a comparison based sorting method. Now the important thing is that whether this sorting is useful or not useful. This sorting is useful or not useful. This is an important question actually. This sorting is useful or not useful. How we can find out this sorting is useful or not useful? So let me tell you one important thing. The complexity of bubble sort is O n square, where n is the number of element. What does it mean? What actually it mean? Let's say if we have any array of 5 elements, so it take how much time? O 5 square. It means it take 25 O notation time to actually implement. So we can say by very clear margin that this sorting is not useful sorting. This sorting is basically a not useful sorting method for any array to sort. Okay, now we come to the mechanism, and we will find out why this sorting is not useful. Let me take an array. Let's see, I have an array. This is a very small array. The very small array of 5 elements. It has 5 elements. How we can actually sort this array by using bubble sort? So in bubble sort, actually it will take array in the comparison base. We will actually use array in the comparison base of basically pairs. Like, see, first of all, we will actually compare these two numbers, and we will easily find out that 2 is the smallest number as comparison to 2 or 3. So we will interchange their position. We will interchange their position, and rest of the numbers will completely same. Then we will take second and third number. And we will try to compare them also. Okay. And here we can easily see that these are number in the perfect order. So we don't need to require. After this, we will actually compare now second and third number. And we can easily say that these two numbers are already in the perfect order. We don't need to actually sort them numbers. So we will write by these number in their order. These number, so we are have to be changed. Like, see, 5 will come first, 8 will come after it, and rest of the all numbers will come completely same. Now after this, we will compare 4th and 5th numbers. Okay, then after so after comparing it, we can easily say this number actually not required position. So it will be 2, 3, 5, 8, and 13. Okay, now we can easily see the sorting actually completed over here. This sorting, this array is already sorted now. This array is already sorted, but we can just find out how many comparison we need to do. How many comparison we need to do? 1, 2, 3, 4, and after this, this array is completed. This array is completed. Let me show you one more example, and that is a complex example, and by which we can easily find out this sorting is actually why not useful too much for bigger elements. See, for the bigger element, we have actually in the page actually we can see very well in this page we are taking 5 elements. So for 5 elements, this sorting look very useful, look good. But what happen if we have actually more elements? Then what we have to do? This sorting required now the time. Let's say I have some numbers 8. Let's say I have this array. This is a complex array. How we can sort that array? By using bubble sort. So let's see, first, second number, comparing, change them the positions. Okay, sorry, change their positions. Let me change the pane so you will understand it much better. Remaining numbers are same. Okay, then after we will do it on the second and third number, change their positions. Okay, but they are already sorted, so no need to change their positions. And remaining numbers are completely in the same position which they are in that. Then we will take this, okay, comparing them, okay, change their positions because it required now. Now we will what? We will be comparing these two numbers, and we will find out there no need of actually sorting methods. There is no need for sorting, so we will write it by this way only. Now we will do it these two numbers, okay, last two numbers, and we will interchange their positions as we will see. Now you can easily see this sorting is actually, this array is actually not sorted completely. Why it is not sorted? Because we are comparing the numbers in the pair of 2. We are comparing the numbers in pair of 2. That's why this sorting is not actually completed now. Then what we have to do? We have to actually restart this process again. Okay. What is our array is? Our array is 2, 8, 7, 13, 11, 15. We will sort that array. Now again we have to restart that entire process. See, we have to restart the entire process again until and unless our array is sorted. So first, again, we have to compare this. Then after, second and third, yes, we need to change it. Then after, we will take third and fourth numbers. No need to change. Okay, I am writing it in the same way. Then after, we will take these two numbers and we have to be change it. And we will just find out that our array is actually sorted now. So see, find out. It required basically 2 steps. How many steps? it required basically two steps. This is step number two. And what actually we did, this is known as step number one. This array is required two steps to complete it, to be sorting. So this actually thing I want to tell you, how many steps can be possible? How many maximum step can be possible for sorting this array? So just see, this array actually have six elements. So what is the maximum step can be possible? Maximum there will be five step possible. Only five steps is it possible maximum for sort this array, because it have six elements. So it required only maximum five steps to be completed in the completed sorted position. To just see in this array actually how many comparison we will do. 1, 2, 3, 4, after this 5 also, I am not writing it here, it's a 5 comparison. Then after, see, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10 comparison for 6 elements. So it's for comparing, it takes lot of time. So see, it can easily visible over here that this sorting is not useful, because it required more and more comparisons, and each and every comparison take more times. So we can easily clearly see at here that this sorting is basically not useful sorting method. What is, we can say that this sorting is not useful sorting for large number of set. It's mean if we have actually very large array, then this sorting is not useful sorting. Okay, so this is the entire mechanism of bubble sorting. Okay, bubble sorting is an in-place sorting. First of all, it means it does not require any extra space. It's a comparison based sorting method. Let me remind everything again back. Yes, what is bubble sort? It's an in-place sorting. In-place sorting means it does not require any extra space. If an array is required 10 KB space, it will actually sort it in that 10 KB space. Then this sorting is useful or not useful. It's a comparison based sorting method. If this sorting is useful or not useful, so the complexity of bubble sort is O n square, where n is the number of element. So we can say if we have 5 elements, then we require how many time? 25 big O notation time. It means that this sorting is not useful. Here I am giving you some examples how we can compare the numbers using bubble sort. Bubble sort compare the numbers in the pair of 2. First, second, then second, then third, fourth, then fourth and fifth, and so on. And this process will repeat it. This process is completely repeat. Again, this process will repeat until and unless if the array is sorted. So this is the entire mechanism of bubble sort. I hope this sorting will look useful for smaller sets of elements. Yes. If we have like 3, 4, 5 numbers, this sorting look useful. But whenever we have large set of numbers, then this sorting look not useful for large set of elements. So this is the entire bubble sort mechanism. Thank you, students.